Hey, I'm Emma Shorty from theschoolofscratch.com, and in this video, I'll teach you how to do the reverse scratch, which sounds like this. The reverse scratch is the second scratch where we combine using the crossfader at the same time as using our jog wheel control hand. It is the complete mirror opposite of the forward scratch. Once again, it does require some coordination, so start slowly to build up your jog wheel hand control and muscle memory. I'll demonstrate it slowly so you can see exactly what is happening. Find the start of your sample. I'm using R, which is at 6 o'clock. Now find the end of your sample and close the crossfader. This is our starting position. Open the crossfader, and once the fader is open, pull the record backwards in one smooth movement, just like you did with the reverse part of the drop. When you get back to the beginning of the sample, so when the marker is back at 6 o'clock, close the crossfader and stop moving the jog wheel. The next step is to push the jog wheel back to the end of the sample, our starting position, while the crossfader is closed. Make sure you use the tape marker and look at that rather than the crossfader. Because the crossfader is closed, it cuts off the forward sound. With this scratch, we only want to hear the reverse sound of the record, hence its name. Let's try that a few more times. Once you can do this slowly, the next step is to increase the speed. Let's hear what it sounds like using a different sound. The fresh sample is a great sound to use. Find some interesting samples and experiment to get a feel for what sounds best. Now let's hear how it sounds with a beat. Now that we've broken it down and you've heard how it sounds over a beat, let's try practicing it together. I'll do the reverse scratch for 4 bars, then leave a gap for you to scratch for 4 bars. Forget perfect and aim for progress. Let's go. Yeah. wraps up the reverse scratch. This is a great scratch for practicing your jog wheel control. It will be really useful when you start creating different scratch combinations. With practice, you will start to get the hang of using the crossfader together with your jog wheel hand to develop the coordination which allows you to create some interesting scratch sounds. Keep practicing and, as always, concentrate on getting your scratches in time with the beat and build up your fader and jog wheel hand coordination. If you'd like to dive in deeper with learning how to scratch, visit schoolofscratch.com and sign up for my complete How to Scratch course.